unto the Lord. Let your song be sung from mountains high. Sing a new song unto the Lord, singing Alleluia.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Jayasuki. Good morning and welcome back to the online Eucharistic celebration. Archbishop Anil has sent a new circular saying that the churches in Delhi will remain closed till 30th of July. That's a kind of a good long full month. So I thought it will be fitting to start the online service. Also, many of you have asked me personally to continue with the service. I also thank our sisters who are making a lot of arrangements to have this Mass done in the most loving manner. So once again, thank you and welcome. God bless you all. May God bring healing to the whole world. So as we come together this morning, my dear brothers and sisters, let us examine ourselves and ask Lord to forgive those moments when we have gone away from His love. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and my words, and in what I have done, and in what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault, therefore I ask Blessed Mary, a Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. Grant, O Lord, that we may always revere and love your holy name, for you never deprive of your guidance those who set firm on the foundation of your love. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from the second book of the Kings. The king of Assyria invaded the whole country and, coming to Samaria, laid siege to it for 3 years. In the ninth year of Hoshea, the king of Assyria captured Samaria and deported the Israelites to Assyria. He settled them in Hela on the Habor, a river of Gozan, and in the cities of Medes. This happened because the Israelites had sinned against the Lord their God, who had brought them out of the land of Egypt, out of the grip of Pharaoh, king of Egypt. They worshipped other gods, they followed the practices of the nations that the Lord had dispossessed for them. And yet, through all the prophets and all the seers, the Lord had given Israel and Judah this warning: turn from your wicked ways and keep my commandments and my law in accordance with the entire law I lay down for your fathers and delivered to them through my servants the prophets. But they would not listen. They were more stubborn than their ancestors had been who had no faith in the Lord their God. They despised his laws and the covenant he had made with their ancestors and the warnings he had given them. For this, the Lord was enraged with Israel and thrust them away from him. There was none left but the tribe of Judah only. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Psalm response. Hear us, O Lord, and help us.
Hear us, O Lord, and help us.
O God, you have rejected us and broken us. You have been angry. Come back to us. Response.
Hear us,
O Lord, and help us. You have made the earth quake, turn it open, repair what is shattered for its sways. You have inflicted hardships on your people and made us drink a wine that dazed us. Response.
Hear us, O Lord, and help us.
Will you utterly reject us, O God, and no longer march with our armies? Give us help against the foe, for the help of man is vain. Response.
Hear us,
O Lord, and help us. Gospel acclamation. Sing alleluia to the Lord.
Sing alleluia to the Lord.
Sing alleluia. Sing alleluia. Sing alleluia to the Lord.
The Lord be with you.
And with your
spirit. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Matthew. Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not judge, and you will not be judged. Because the judgments you give are the judgments you will get, and the amount you measure out is the amount you will be given. Why do you observe the splinter in your brother's eye and never notice the plank in your own? How dare you to say to your brother, 'Let me take the splinter out of your eye,' when all the time there is a plank in your own? Hypocrite, take the plank out of your own eye first, and then you will see clearly enough to take the splinter out of your brother's eye." The Gospel of the Lord. May the words of the Gospel wipe away our sins and offenses. My dear brothers and sisters, one of the most difficult axioms of Jesus places before us is this: to not judge. Even though you and I do not intend to judge, the judgment definitely happened to all of us. Every morning you get up and say, "Today I would walk righteously and I wouldn't judge." But we will look at a person, we make a comment, a judgment is actually thrown on. In the traditional way, the church used to have something called an examination of the conscience in the night before you go to sleep. Some people do it still, and the religious congregations continue to do that examinations of the conscience. What is important is, when you do that, you know actually the path you walked. You were able to observe the plank and the difficulty that each of us play undergo. We understand the weakness that we are in. In such situation, it will be easier to help others and to deal with other persons with utmost love. So what is more important to all of us today is to examine ourselves every morning and evening and help, ask God's help to lead a life of virtue. May the Lord bless us to live by His promptings. Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Oh,
the hearts as well and consecrate them to you.
This time, Lord God, for the worship of the Lord, to offer for the earth and work of the spiritual food.
Offering beyond the simple of your children, holy sacrifice.
Bless our Lord God of all creatures and for the good of this wine to offer for the
prayer of
God. We ask to receive and be pleased with the sacrifice we offer to our Lord.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Receive, O Lord, the sacrifice of conciliation and praise, and grant that, cleansed by its action, we may make offering of heart pleasing to you, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For just as through your beloved Son you created the human race, so also through him with great goodness you formed it anew. And so it is right that all your creatures serve you, all the redeemed praise you, and all the saints with one heart bless you. Therefore we too extol you with all the angels as in joyful celebration we acclaim,
holy,
holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread. Giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Once more giving you thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. For by your cross and resurrection you have set us free. You have set us free. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Anil, our Bishop, and all the clergy, religious and laity. Remember also our parents, brothers and sisters, friends and well-wishers. No love fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection. No love died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Mary, Virgin Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coerced to eternal life. We praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to the apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with the will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let's offer each other the sign of peace. Wish with you. You take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Namo God, you take away the sins of the world, mercy on us. Namo God, may the body and blood of the Lord Jesus Christ bring it to me like this. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord,
I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. May the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ keep us safe for eternal life. Amen. Let us do the spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Make me a servant. be a servant, humble and meek. Lord, let me lift up those who are weak.
My mouth and appointed me a prophet to the world. Make me a servant, humble and meek. Lord, let me lift up those who are weak, and may the prayer of my heart always be.
Make me a servant, make me a servant, make me a servant today.
Let us pray. Renewed and nourished by the sacred body and the precious blood of your Son, we ask of your mercy, O Lord, that what we celebrate with constant devotion may be our sure pledge of redemption through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your
spirit. May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in the love of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
For the intentions of the Archdiocese of Delhi, of your congregations, for family, in a very special way for the whole world, we ask Mary's intercession. Remember, O most gracious Virgin Mary, that never was it known that anyone hoped for your protection, implore your help and certain intercession, was left unaided, inspired with this confidence, I fly unto you, O Virgin of Virgins, my Mother. To you I come, before you I stand, sinful and sorrowful. O Mother of Word Incarnate, despise not my petition, but in your mercy hear and answer me. Amen. Mary, your Mother, Queen of Peace and Channel of all grace. So thank you very much for celebrating this Mass with me. Have a good day. God bless you.